First up tonight, we attend Miami City Ballet's Open Barre Series featuring choreographer Justin Peck's Heatscape. Before the sneak peek at this Wynwood-inspired ballet, we caught up with Peck to discuss the South Florida connections to the piece and his experience with the Miami City Ballet.
So tonight is an Open Barre Series, which is our in-studio, up close and personal, very intimate setting performance. We're both, I think, a little nervous because we're going to be workshopping basically part of or excerpts of Justin Peck's new ballet called Heatscape.
And the great thing about this is that he's collaborated with a street artist named Shepard Ferry, who you can see all over Wynwood walls and in many places, actually in Miami. He's a phenomenal street artist. And the two of them, Shepard and Justin, have collaborated and they've come together. Shepard has created the backdrop for Justin's ballet and Justin has created the choreography.
Art is for everyone. It's not just for the elite.
When I was first coming down to Miami to work with the company here, I started to explore the Wynwood Arts District, which has a really amazing street art scene. Like, it's such a mecca for that kind of artwork. And so, and then I found that Shepard's work was really at the heart of everything that was going on there. And, you know, beyond that, I thought that Shepard's work could translate really well into theatrical setting.
Justin was inspired when he saw Shepard's Fairy. There, as an artist, he had a reaction to Shepard's work, and that's the first thing you need when you're a choreographer specifically, because you want to be able to put that reaction or that relevancy actually on the stage. And the other thing that's interesting is that Justin is a ballet choreographer, Shepard is a street artist. One comes from a very traditional background in terms of an art form. Ballet has a lot of parameters, has a lot of protocol, it's about social manners, a lot of tradition, and street art is rogue, it's today, it's the latest thing that's happening. So to have these two art forms coming together from completely opposite sides of the railroad tracks, actually, is just very cool.
I think that dancers really appreciate having the choreographer's presence in the studio and demanding certain things from the dancer is something that they really value, and I'm able to use my outlook and my eye to bring out certain qualities within these dancers themselves. And so I think I'm able to kind of like harness their abilities and challenge them in a way that really excites them.
Yeah, and he's really specific about giving you certain analogies and certain details about the movement that kind of open your eyes and see it in a new way, so then you find yourself dancing in a new way. And I even see that when I watch other dancers do his work, I feel like I'm watching dancers for the first time, and I think that's something really special about his work.
I found them to be really inspiring. I think that they have a quickness and athleticism and also a really nice sense of camaraderie amongst them that works in the company's favor to really produce great work.
One of my favorite things about working with him is his ability to use the entire company to feel so much like a team. Sometimes, you know, when you're a principal dancer in the court of ballet, you work a lot individually and then you all of a sudden come back together and you really don't interact as much. And he has a really special way of making it feel like this community and this play and really feeling like we're humans who are dancers.
I like the fact that I was able to give them a platform for them to express themselves, you know, in regards to who they are, as opposed to them portraying a role.
Not so much, you know, putting on the tiara and the tutu and doing what has been done in the past. And I think the whole company is feeling so energized by this process of working together to create something brand new.
There's like a life within it. There's like a vitality within the art form. And so I think this piece encapsulates a lot of that. I think there's a certain energy in the music and certain energy in the choreography, and something that's also brought out through the dancers themselves.
There are three movements to the ballet, and it's fun because Justin likes to use every dancer in all movements. So a lot of times in certain ballets, when you have a special part, you wait for the first and the second movement to go by, and then all of a sudden you have to go out and dance in the third. But I specifically have more to do in the third, and it's a lot of exciting turns and fun interacting with and weaving in and out of a group, and so it's challenging but very fun.
Eats Cape is young, it's fast, it's edgy, but the interesting thing is that it's a classical vocabulary, so it's the same steps that you see in Swan Lake and Giselle. It's the same exact steps and shapes and gestures, but just in a very contemporary, modern format.
It's interesting to see how the ballet is developing, because we kind of don't know when it's a premiere of a brand new ballet where it's going to go. And I don't even know if Justin knew where he was going to go when he started.
Right.
So it's kind of fun to see how it evolves
exactly. Yeah.
One of the biggest challenges of working on this specific commission was kind of making sure it all comes together in the right way, and we're still kind of making sure that that happens. I'm really happy to be here working with Miami City Ballet, and I consider them to be one of the most exciting companies around today.
It's a very Miami piece, and that's what artists do. Artists take from their environment and they put it out in their art form. So I think it's going to be a direct connection. I mean, the curtain's going to go up, and I think people are going to feel the energy and the vibe of the city, but on the stage.
The Miami City Ballet world premiere of Heatscape is March 27, 2015 at the Kravis Center for the Performing Arts in West Palm Beach, Florida. For ticket information, call the Miami City Ballet box office or visit miamicityballet.org.